Bill Kelly leading off, and the Yankees on top 4-3. Garland Kaiser delivers, and Kelly takes a strike, a breaking ball. We have seen a lot of breaking stuff from Kaiser in the appearances he has made. He worked a couple. There's a line drive, base hit into left. So Kelly is aboard, picking up his first hit. So the Yankees have the leadoff man on. And Mel Hall, who homered in the fourth inning, will bat. Mel hitting 285 with 19 home runs and 80 runs batted in.
Nah, I don't think he's going to give you the bunt sign, Mel.
Kaiser came on in relief. Worked parts of a couple innings yesterday in relief of Eric King. Roberto is back in. Kelly with his stolen base in the sixth inning has matched Steve Sachs, each with 31 stolen bases. Eighth in the American League.
And I think that's why Bernie Williams, continuing to progress, especially in the stolen base department, and if they can find a place somehow for Pat Kelly. When they go out in those artificial surface teams, that speed becomes so much more important. Not just offensively, when you want to start a runner and maybe pick up an extra base, but defensively.
Roberto at first base. Kaiser again with a little toss to first. Kelly returning. The Yankees have had a tough time keeping the lead late in the last couple of games against the Indians. Leading by one in the eighth in this game. Hall had the off-speed pitch, off-speed breaking ball. 1-1. It's a final now on the Wiz scoreboard. The Jets have beaten the Cleveland Browns 17-14. Toss to first. Kelly again back in. The Bernie Kosar fumble set up the Jets' victory over the Browns. Runners going. Breaking ball is a ball and a steal for Roberto Kelly, number 32.
Breaks the tie with Steve Sachs.
Boy, what a finish. Roberto Kelly's had stealing bases, hitting home runs.
But the two catches
he's
made so far today.
The last couple of weeks, he has been red hot. And he's hit the ball all over the place. All chasing the breaking ball.
And that may tell the organization the way he has responded now. You don't want to ever give a guy that much time off, but it was injury related with Roberto Kelly that trying to get him, allowing him to play 162 games as they did, maybe too much, and he gets worn down. And I think, again, that's the bench that you hope is rebuilt next year. He'll be much more effective if he gives you 155 games and 162.
Pickoff play at second. Lewis slipping in and Roberto back in head first. Boy, that's one of the things that Tom Kelly over in Minnesota did well this year. He rotated that lineup.
He was doing that in June.
Yep.
Planning for August and September.
Breaking ball again. A full count to Mel Hall. The Yankees have 4 runs and 6 hits. They have played long ball today. They've hit 3 home runs, accounting for all 4 runs. And now 3-2 to Mel Hall. He fouls it. So Kaiser will come in with another 3-2 pitch. Matt Noakes, another left-handed bat on deck. There's Matt. He is 0 for 3 today. 3-2. Breaking ball, and down he goes on ball four. So Kaiser staying with that curveball. Walks Mel Hall. First and second with nobody out.
Kaiser was going to throw a little bit harder curveball. Mel starts diving in, trying to protect the outside part of the plate, and just barely gets out of the way.
Kramer throwing in the bullpen again. And Matt Noakes is at the plate. Noakes, nothing of three, called out on strikes in the fourth inning, struck out swinging in the sixth. Facing the left-hander for the first time in this game. Are going to be loaded. Roberto Kelly advances to third and stops there on Noakes' base hit into center. They're loaded for Jim Leyritz.
Could be a right-hander coming in. I would guess.
Der Kaiser surrendered a base hit to Kelly, walked Hall, and now a single to Noakes, and Hargrove comes out of the Indians' dugout.
If he does make a move to Tommy Kramer, we could see Torrey Lovello come in to hit for Leyritz.
And then Moss, of course, behind Leyritz in the order, or whomever would hit.
I think right now, Mike Hargrove, who he's managing as if he wants to sweep this series, and that's the way it should be. He's just trying to prevent a big inning and wants to think of Leyritz first. And
so Tom Kramer is going to be the new pitcher. Kaiser struck out Mattingly to end the seventh inning. That's the only out he gets. Gives up two hits and a walk as well. So he entered the game with a couple of men on, left them on. And now Kramer will inherit a bases loaded situation after the base hit by Noakes. We'll be back in a moment. The Yankees are wrapping up this season here. One of the most quotable quotes, I guess, Patrick Ewing of the Knicks. Our New York Times quote of the week, happy for Michael Jordan when he won the championship, but hard for Patrick Ewing to sit there and watch it. He admitted to being jealous. I want that situation to be me. So maybe that is a good sign.
Was it that poor a week for the Yankees? We can't find Wooden. Quote of the week from Mal Hall or someone?
Jim Leyritz will hit for himself against the hard-throwing right-hander, Tom Kramer. And the first pitch too high, ball one.
Kramer tried to snap off some sliders in his eight warm-up pitches, but they weren't breaking for him. And if you're not a deck hitter, you probably want to watch what his pitch selection is.
This one foul into the upper deck. If this guy can throw strikes, and that's a big if. Bases loaded here. Kelly third, Hall second, and Noakes at first. He's tough to handle because he can throw hard. And a chopper foul down the left side. One and two.
You know, you look at his minor league strikeout base on balls ratio, wasn't too bad. Last season, one level of Kinston, 96 strikeouts, just 29 base on balls. And the next level of same year, Canton Akron, was excellent also, about 4-1.
Down and in. It's a two ball, two strike count. Nobody out. Close again. But off the plate and a full count. Yankees lead by a run. We're in the bottom of the eighth. And he walks it, forcing home a run. The run charge to Kaiser makes it 5-3. The bases loaded walk will earn Leyritz a run batted in. And Kevin Moss, the Yankee first baseman, will bat. So Roberto Kelly scores his second run of the day. And here's Moss. Kevin with a couple of home runs, 2 out of 3. And he takes this one inside, ball one. Hall at third, Noakes at second, and Leyritz, the base runner at first. They're loaded up for Moss. The 1-0 pitch, strike on the outside edge, 1-1.
Kevin, a good part of this year has had difficulty with mid and scoring position, so in this situation, it could be a further boost to him. If he can at least have a hit the ball hard somewhere, forget him getting a base hit, but if he hits it hard somewhere, has a quality at bat, it could be important to him.
The 1-1, way wide. Two balls and a strike.
Yeah, it's almost like overkill when you say one at bat could be important, but I think to Kevin Moss it is. I mean, he was moved out of the fourth spot because he wasn't hitting with men in scoring position.
Ball three blocked by Talvin's in. It pops halfway back down toward the mound. Kramer coming off the hill just in case that ball skipped by Taubenzy. And it's a 3-1 count.
Well, this guy's got a herky-jerky delivery and bounces this and 4 feet in front of Taubenzy. Willie Blair. He's out of Toronto Blue Jays organization.
3-1. Short center. Mayorga goes out there and makes the catch. And now the tag by Kelly. He's going to try, or rather by Hall, and he will score. So Mel Hall hustles home after the catch.
Mel was just waiting to see which of the three converging would catch on it. Actually, four. And if it had been an outfielder coming into home plate, he wouldn't have gone. But with Mayorga's back to the plate, Mel Hall alertly pounds home.
So the Yankees pick up their second run of the inning, and here it is. Mayorga not in the greatest of positions to get a throwaway, and Hall taking advantage of that scores.
How in the world did Mayorga get there with Moss at bat? Short left field. Where was Mark Lewis? Shortstop.
Yep.
Well, can you imagine the length of his runs? Lewis must have lost that ball completely.
He got sort of turned around, I think, out there and was searching. And Cole coming in, and Mayorga came on and made quite a play.
Was that for a sacrifice fly? No time at bat because of Mel Hall.
Inside, 1-1, and he picks up another run batted in. Espinosa waiting. The third foul. A ball, 2 strikes. So the Yankees have padded their lead with a couple runs in the bottom of the eighth to make it 6-3. Still only one out with Noakes at second and Leyritz on first. That's out of play. Espinosa hitting .257. He's hit an infield hit to short back in the seventh inning. And he stays alive, battling Kramer, fouling another one out of play. fourth Cleveland pitcher. And he throws this one by Espinosa. Alvaro couldn't catch up.
That was a throw hard. That ball sailed. It looks like that fastball's lively. With that kind of delivery, must be tough to pick the ball up.
Two outs in the eighth inning. And now the number nine hitter for the Yankees, Bernie Williams. Bernie doubled in the third. He is one for three. Have still been out hit by one, but lead by three. And Bernie takes a strike. Bernie hitting 235. For a base hit. Noakes being waved home, and the throw pops away from Talbinsey, and Noakes is safely in. It's a three-run inning and a 7-3 ball game. Leyritz stopped at second, and Bernie Williams drops a single in the center. He couldn't come up with the ball cleanly.
We saw Noakes score yesterday by knocking the ball out of Talbinsey's hands with his head. Boy, was Talbinsey in a bad position to feel that. He could have gotten really knocked over instead of being out in fair territory. We'd get the ball sooner and help prevent from getting collided with.
Sachs gets another at bat and takes the pitch for a ball.
Good thing Matthew Noakes didn't do to Talbinsey, but Albert Bell hit to Matthew Noakes.
Yeah.
Whoa, is Talbinsey in a vulnerable position?
These runs charged to Kaiser, and down goes Sachs. 2-0 the count.
Ledger staying about 95 on your speed gun. And fast gun, I'll bet you it's close to that.
Yep.
Ooh.
Two nothing the count here on Steve Sachs. Fly ball into right. Kirby is there, reaching up to make the catch, and the Yankees are finished in the eighth, but they score three. They leave a couple men, and as we take this one into the ninth, it's 7-3 Yankees. New York Yankee baseball is brought to you in part by your New York, New Jersey GMC truck dealers. We're going into the ninth. Torrey Lovello takes over at third base for Jimmy Leyritz. Torrey Lovello at third. Jerry Brown will pinch hit here to open the ninth inning. He'll be hitting for Aldretti against Lee Guterman. The Yankees lead 7-3.
Going to be a good all-around player, if not for the Indians, for somebody else, is a guy who's hit nearly 300 and shown he can play left field a little bit, play second base a little bit, you can play him at third.
It's a strike on the outside corner.
It's an outstanding job for the Indians as a pinch hitter.
He fouls it out of play. He has done a very good job pinch hitting. Tomey is on deck. And then Talbinsey, a couple of left-handed bats due to follow Brown. And up the middle for Espinosa.
Look at that.
He got it. Alvaro Espinosa to Kevin Moss to get the pinch hitter Brown.
Not as sensational looking as the dive he made to his left early in the ballgame and popped out and threw a runner out. Espy covers a lot of ground. By the time he unleashed this throw off balance, he was well on the first base side of second.
Now, Tony Perez Chica has a bat and has come into the on-deck circle. So he'll hit for Tomey. There's Chica hitting for Tomey. Tomey finishes 1-for-3. Yankees with 3 in the 8th to pad this lead.
There's Chica out of the San Francisco Giants organization. This season, part with Phoenix, the AAA ball club, and San Francisco, who's claimed off the waiver wires. John Hart, the GM, watches so diligently, and you got to do that, especially when you're in the rebuilding process. Pick up some of those spare parts.
And the pitch is in there for a strike. Guterman in relief of Dave Island. This is Island's game to win. And a liner foul through the seats. 0-2 the count.
Well, we got a chance. I better talk. We better all thank some of New York City's finest.
Oh, of course.
You know, for
they've been great.
Crowd control outside the stadium, keeping the place safe. Your friend from the Transit Authority, Roy Schutte and the boys, for all those safe trips back and forth in the subway for some of us, and especially Yankee fans.
Yep. This one alone. They've been great.
Oh, yeah.
Absolutely no question about that. Looking forward to seeing everyone back next year.
To you coming?
The schedule. Oh, why not?
A little too.
Sure.
Give me one more shot.
And a base hit. Off a 1-2 pitch, Perez Chica singles into left. So the Indians now have 9 hits, the third surrendered by Guterman. And now we'll have Luis Lopez pinch hit for Talbonzi. So 3 consecutive pinch hitters. Lopez hitting 210. We saw him enter the game in the 8th inning yesterday as a pinch hitter and walk and then stayed on.
Got a base hit later on.
Yep. In the 12th inning.
So everybody had a base hit sometime during yesterday's game, especially if they were leading off.
So Lopez hits with a man at first and one out. This one out of play.
You got an MVP that you'd pick in the American League? I'd pick him, Ripken.
Ripken. Yeah, we talked about him in the Baltimore series. I don't think there's any question in my mind.
National League's a little tougher.
Ripken, and I have a tendency to lean toward Pendleton a little bit.
I certainly do too. Not just because he's had a good year hitting and defensively, but what he's meant solidifying the clubhouse atmosphere for Bobby Cox. Me too. You look at Strawberry, and you look at Bonds and Bonilla. Brett Butler, some people talk about. Boy, when you look at Pendleton's contribution, he has changed that mystique, that they talk about in that clubhouse.
He was one of the ingredients they evidently needed, and boy, he's had an MVP year.
Glavin for Cy Young, Tommy Glavin. Willie Smith.
Yeah.
Smith's had a heck of a year for the Cardinals.
Lee Smith. All those saves of the Cardinals, but Glavin has been the force for the Braves as well. Up the middle, through into center field. On his way to third, Perez Chica, first and third with one out.
Might be a perfect time in the National League for best player. You got to start thinking Howard Johnson then in the Mets.
So now we'll have another pinch hitter. Wayne Kirby will be lifted, and Jose Gonzalez will hit.
There's John Habian.
You know, when you start to look at the Yankee staff, of course, Scott Sanderson has been so great for them this year. And Stump Merrill comes out here with men at first and third and one out, Habian in the bullpen. Habian certainly has. He's going to receive a lot of consideration for the best Yankee pitcher. Notwithstanding the job Sanderson did and Steve Barr.
You could have made a good case for him as Al Trautwein did and the staff putting that piece together for Yankee Player of the Year. Mel Hall won it.
Well, that's it for Guterman. The Yankees are going to make a pitching change. Guterman departs and Habian will get the call.
And Mike Hargrove has no left-handed hitter to change to replace Gonzalez.
So Guterman departs after pitching an inning and a third, allowing four hits, so not, far a run.
Not too happy, it didn't appear either.
Oh. So Habian comes on and will depart. We'll be right back in a moment. John Habian, the new pitcher for the Yankees here in the ninth, with the Yankees holding a 7-3 lead. Two men on with one out. So Gonzalez, called upon to hit for Kirby, stays on. And Habian's first pitch is a strike.
He has been better than anybody could have ever imagined after 2 years off with his shoulder problems.
Trying to finish this one. That one stayed up. Gonzalez darting out of there, 1-1. David Cone struck out 19 Philadelphia Phillies as the Mets finish off the Phillies 7-0. Steve Carlton and Tom Seaver also struck out 19, and Clemens with 20, the major league record. Foul ball, one ball, two strikes. So David Cone with 19 strikeouts against the Phillies today in a 7-0 win.
Unlike the Yankees, the Mets are still, in my mind, in a fine-tuning process with just a few adjustments to be a contender in the Eastern Division National. The Yankees have to do a little bit more, maybe considerably more.
This one foul back. So the count holding right there at a ball, two strikes. Island for seven, Guterman for an inning and a third. Upstairs, that squares the count. 2-2. The only save this year for Habian came back in the middle of May here in Yankee Stadium over the Angels for Pascual Perez. He is 4-2. Otherwise, the 2-2. He got him. Strike three call. Gonzalez is not happy. It's the first strikeout I have for Yankee pitching today. And the second out of the ninth. Here's another look.
Certain Gonzalez thought this pitch was too high, and it's right around the belt. Tell you, guys like John Habian and Dwayne Ward up in Toronto, where Ward has had chances to save ball games when Hickey went down, you really think they should make that hold an official major league stat.
Alex Cole back through the middle, and it hits the bag at second. One run is home. Stopping at second base, Lopez, a base hit for Cole. Perez Chicas scores to make it a 7-4 ball game. That run will be charged to Guterman. Cole got it right back through the middle, and it hit the bag at second base.
Almost looked like that ball fooled John Habian. I don't know if he thought it was hit harder. It looked like he was going to reach for it in one area. And then he gets the break by hitting the second base bag. That hit right there would have fit well in yesterday's ball game.
Yep. Here's Mark Lewis, and it's too high, ball one.
The Yankees end up having to guard the lines. Lewis being the tying run.
Yep, 7-4, two men on, two men out, and a strike at the knees. The count is 1-1.
Suggests Mark Lewis start the bat and start swinging at anything close.
And he fouls this one up the right side. A ball, two strikes now. So Habian, a strike away from closing this one out. And putting the finishing touch on the 1991 season. The fans are on their feet here.
I mean, these are the true Yankee fans right here, standing en masse.
A ball, two strikes. And it's all over. Lewis strikes out. And the Yankees win this one. Habian comes on to pick up two strikeouts as the Yankees defeat the Cleveland Indians 7-4 to wrap up the series and the season. In the ninth inning for Cleveland, one run, three hits, couple of men left on base for the Indians in that frame. And the Yankees have avoided being swept by this ball club. The Indians had taken the first two games, and the Yankees get seven good innings from Dave Island, who gave up just two runs on six hits, and then finished off with Guterman and Habian in this 7-4 win.
So Mal Hall leads the ball club in RBIs with his two-run home run. Kevin Moss was sneaking up on Matthew Noakes with his two home runs today for the home run leadership on this ball club. And Roberto Kelly excelled one more day. And Island, with his off-speed stuff, was quite impressive today.
He pitched very well to earn his second win.
You're seeing one of the reasons why a lot of youngsters like to come to the last game. It is not unusual for home team players to start flipping balls, even an old glove or a couple of caps beyond the dugout. A couple of souvenirs right then.
17,000 plus the attendance here in the final day of the year. And our New York Times play of the day, home run number two of the day for Kevin Moss. It came in the seventh on a 3-2 pitch. Moss connects for the 23rd time this year. He had belted one in the fifth inning, hit number two of the day in the seventh, and that is our New York Times play of the game. The Yankees have beaten the Indians 7-4. We'll be back in a moment. The final 7-4 on the final day of the year for the Yankees. They have beaten the Cleveland Indians here at Yankee Stadium to put the finishing touch on the 1991 season, a time of saying goodbye and to say thank you to so many people around, including our technical crew, our cameraman, and all the fellows in the truck, everyone who contributed to our performance this year as the Yankees on MSG rolled into and now beyond their third season. Looking forward to a new year next year, 1992. One of the fellows we'll be bidding adieu to for just a while until next spring would be Kevin Moss, the slugger who belted a couple of home runs today. Al Trotwig is standing by with Kevin right now.
All right, Dwayne, thank you. Now, if you don't think that there's any mechanical tinkering, even on the last day of the season, just talk to Kevin Moss, who actually made a change after the first at-bat. What could that have been, Kevin?
Well, I think that my second and third at-bats, I had similar pitches as I did my first at-bat, but I did something my first at-bat, pulled my shoulder off a little bit, didn't get a good look at the ball, and the result was a weak fly ball to center field. So it's kind of the same thing that I've been doing for the last couple months, and tried to correct it, and knew what I needed to do. And
how did you know what you needed to do? Is that just a matter of muscle memory and you feel it wrong, or did Frank Howard say something? Or
no, it's kind of a feel, and something that I know that has been working for me the last month. I felt like I've been hitting the ball a little better the past three to four weeks, and at least when I made good contact, the ball had good carry on it, and so I knew that was part of the problem. So I tried to stay on the back leg and keep the shoulder in, and good things happen.
All right, let's take a look at one of the good things that happened. 22nd home run of the season. This is the first of two in the game today. Charles Nagy on the mound for the Cleveland Indians, and here it comes with that mechanical adjustment.
Yeah, well, you can see there, my front shoulder stayed on the ball a lot longer, and in the situation in the last inning where I popped up to short, I kept it in a little too long and got jammed. So, but I think I'd rather have that happen than the other way around, where you pull off the ball and you hit it off the end of the bat. You can have a lot more good things happen when you keep your shoulder in.
Is this a minor thing that you do from time to time, or is this the realization of something that you've been doing for a longer period of time?
Well, I think it certainly hasn't been minor, because that's been my problem most of the season, especially when I started struggling after the break, after the All-Star break, because I wasn't driving the ball, and that was a big part of the problem. I was lunging at the ball, I wasn't keeping my shoulder in, and that resulted in really a slow bat, and no bat speed. Mm-hmm. And, so it was a lot of lazy flies.
Kevin, what feeling do you think you'll have going into spring training next year? Certainly, you know you're going to work hard in the offseason, but, you know, in terms of DH and field player, you could have a little bit more competition than you may have coming into this season. You got John Ramos, who could play a role in a DH spot. Mm-hmm. What do you think you're going to be thinking when you come back to Fort Lauderdale?
Well, that's a few months away. I don't know. I think more than anything, I'm going to try to work on my game a little bit this winter, go down to Venezuela for a month. Just really try to make myself the best player I can be coming into spring training. And I realized that I have to win a job in spring. That's the way I felt this year. Granted, I had a little more leeway, I think, coming into this spring. But I expect to have to win a job next spring. It's not going to be any different than it ever has before. You know, there's other people fighting for your
right.
job. So,
what time's your flight?
Well, actually, it's tomorrow, so I'm looking forward to going home and packing up and relaxing a little bit and maybe catch a movie. And I didn't have to worry about any rain today, so.
Heading home to California.
Yep.
All right. Thanks, Kevin.
Okay, yeah.
Two home runs today, part of a Yankee victory. A nice way for the Yankees to end the season. Hour of four this afternoon at Yankee Stadium in front of a crowd announced at 17,000, the offseason began. The Yankees won today over the Cleveland Indians, salvaging some pride out of the series and recording a mark on the season of 71-91. For the record, it was 7-4 the final. But just to make things interesting and tease us back to thoughts of yesterday, the Indians did bring the potential tying one run to the plate. In this game today, Kevin Moss launched two home runs. That's a very good ending in a season that has been less than good. And Mel Hall, who has struggled down the stretch of the season, the better part of 5 weeks, also launched a home run to the porch and right. And that's a good ending for our Yankee Player of the Year. Overall, a lot of indecision now as you look around the Yankee locker room. You look at each and every Yankee, Stump Merrill, every one of the coaches, and wonder which are the ones that you'll see when we return to Fort Lauderdale in the spring for our coverage next year of the New York Yankees. The video story of today's game is next to come, and I learned one thing. That is that my fan club has one more member than I thought it did. Now, if we can get rid of that picture, we'll take you to the bottom of the fourth inning. 1-0 Indians. Mel Hall ends his season on the high note I spoke about. A career-high 19th home run. Roberto Kelly was aboard, and that gave the Yankees a lead of 2-1. Bottom of the fifth. Kevin Moss gives the Yankees the lead even bigger. Kevin Moss, his solo home run to right for his 22nd of the year. UConn alum Charles Nagy now down by the count of 3-1. Now we jump to the bottom of the seventh. Indians have closed to within one. Here's Moss again, showcasing the swing that the Yankees had wished they had seen so many more times this year at the stadium. A solo shot to right center, number 23, second of the game. Yankees led it 4-2. Jumped in front and eventually won this one by the score of 7-4. Bernie Williams kept things going as the Yankees increased their lead. Matt Noakes slid across as Eddie Taubes, he couldn't hold on to the throw. Now the final out of the game, John Habian on in relief of Lee Guterman. And for the last time and 71st time this season, Stump Merrill does the victory thing. So that's the story of today's game. The player of today's game is Kevin Moss, the Citgo performer of the game. Citgo, home of high-quality gasolines with HTA 1000 Super Detergent, salutes his two home run, three RBI performance today. Still to come, Michael Kay in the locker room, and some final thoughts on the season that was when we come back to the stadium in a moment.
Yankee fans, you could win a trip to next year's Yankee spring training in the Rickle Yankee Spring Training Sweepstakes. You and a friend will spend 4 days of sun and fun in Fort Lauderdale and receive tickets to two Yankee preseason games. To enter, stop by your local Rickle Home Center, look for the special display, and fill out the official entry blank. All entries must be received by October 12th. Enter today. Remember, Rickle helps you do it better for less.
Believe this.
2-1 on Dave Henderson. There he goes. The pitch is a ball, and the throw is in time. Matt Noakes throws him out, and Ricky Henderson will have to wait. And he got it.
Oh, with a great change.
Wow, went way out in front, and this game is over. The Yankees have beaten the Toronto Blue Jays tonight, and Steve Howe, by working a perfect ninth and picking up two strikeouts, will post the save. And the 3-2 of the runners in motion. And a double for Bernie Williams, chasing home two more. And the Yankee lead is 5-1 as Bernie Williams picks up his first triple.
To consider on the 2-0 pitch. Now it's 2-1. And a foul ball bounced down the right side. And the count is square, 2-2. Into this.
The world's biggest cheerleader. I don't mean just in size, I mean being vocal and all else. The outfield from Boston are playing deep now. They don't want an extra base hit to score that runner from first.
2-2.
Drive deep down.